equipotential surface for a dipole. Two equal and opposite charges placed in front of each other like this. First you draw the field lines and then draw the equipotential surface. First draw the electric field lines and then perpendicular to that you try to draw the surface. Have you drawn the field lines? The field lines we have already drawn earlier classes. Yes or no?
Yes.
It's a crab. Drawn right. Now equipotential surface should be perpendicular to these field lines. Can you try to draw the equipotential surface? Can you draw first equipotential surface, which is very obvious?
Line in the middle.
Line in the middle.
Yeah.
Good. So this is the equipotential surface. Can you tell me what is the potential of this line? Zero. KQ by this distance minus KQ by that distance. Zero. So throughout this line potential is zero. Draw two more.
Is it like this?
This is plus Q and this is minus Q. So K plus Q by this distance plus K minus Q by that distance. So it becomes zero.
So it will be like this.
Put it behind also. Make it complete. All other equipotential surfaces will be closed.
What you have drawn?
Draw a field line, don't forget that. You started drawing some, modern art. What is that? What is this? No, not like that. It can't have two curves. So this is convex as well as concave. Can't be both curvatures. Only one curvature. This is convex. Are you an artist? Okay, see, the thing is, it should be perpendicular, right? So it will be like that, and then this is how it will be. How many of you have drawn like this? How do you check whether you have drawn correct or not? No, that is one thing, but then even mine is not 100% perpendicular. Here, this side should be flatter, and that side should bulge out. Okay? See, the lines are, between these two charges, lines are like this. So when you have to cut it perpendicular, automatically it becomes flat. Fine? Now, another one. Suppose you have two positive charges. Can you draw the field lines and then the equipotential surface? Drawn the field lines, it will be same.
Exact same.
No.
Inside it will be bulged. And it will be exact opposite.
Exact opposite or exact same?
Sir, it's like a reflection. Yeah. It will be reflection.
No. No.
The bulge comes in. That's what it is. If you have slipped the version of that.
Free to say whatever. Free to say whatever. This is what the field line will be, right? Now, as most of you have correctly understood, the bulge will be inward. The nature of field lines are like that. If you draw perpendicular, the bulge will be inverse and flattened out outside. So one of the curve will be infinity. Throughout this entire thing, potential will be same. Okay? And then you'll get curve like this. It will envelop the infinity. How many of you got this? You got the infinity? Infinity was the main thing. I mean, it is like if bulge is inward, they will meet.
The bulges are meeting.
Then see, two bulges are meeting. Okay.
I actually did.
You all the time say that.
I didn't draw it like an infinity, but it looks like.
But you are thinking
about. No, it looks like.
Your thought is infinite.
Yeah, that's fair.
It encompasses every answer.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to do some integration, basic integration to find the, you want to find out the potential due to other distribution of charges, the way I did there, or you, do that? Okay, so write down, potential. Due to a circular charge. Stop talking. Now suppose Q charge is distributed on this ring. Q charge is uniformly distributed on the ring of radius R. We need to find potential at this point. Achha, by the way, potential is scalar or a vector? It is a scalar. It is a scalar because it is defined as potential energy per unit charge. It is a scalar, so you don't have to care about the direction. Okay, now that's the hint. Find the potential at that point. At the center. What will be electric field at the center? How much?
Zero.
Zero. Anyone got the answer?
We are finding at the center.
Electric field is related to potential like how? E is equal to dV by dr. So E is 0, so derivative of potential is 0. But potential need not be 0. Should I do it? Okay, let me do this one. Suppose you consider a small charge dq over here. So what is the potential due to this dq? What is it? dv is equal to k times dq by r. It's a point charge, right? dq is a small charge. Right? This is the potential. So total potential is integral of this. Now k and r are constants. So this will be k by r integral dq, which will be K capital Q by R. Okay? Fine? Does it matter whether Q is uniformly or non-uniformly distributed? Does it matter? It doesn't matter. Because the integral of dQ will be Q only, whether it is uniformly or non-uniformly distributed. Okay? Total charge KQ by R. So in any charge distribution, if all the charges are at the fixed distance from a point, the potential will be K times total charge by R. Simple. Okay? Fine? Now you have, let's say, a circular charge and you are trying to find potential at a distance Z away from the axis, along the axis. Radius is R, total charge is Q. The ring is like this and you are finding along this line.
It's a ring.
Ring. Ring of charge. How much is the potential at this point? All the charges are fixed distance or not?
Yeah.
What is the answer? No one?
KQ by root of Z square.
V is equal to KQ divided by root over R square plus Z square. Any doubt? All the charges are at a distance of root over Z R square plus Z square only. Okay?